إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. My brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed this ummah, the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with a perfect religion, practices, rituals, seasons of obedience that maintain and keep you on the straight path. The concept of salvation in Islam, brothers and sisters in Islam, is something that you earn yourself. You earn your salvation by adhering to these commands. Here we are just 1 month and a half ago, Ramadan, with all the beautiful things in Ramadan left us, the month of fasting, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised those who fast sincerely for the sake of Allah, they will have their sins forgiven. Promise those who pray sincerely for the sake of Allah that they will have their sins forgiven. And the ummah now is just 15 days almost away from the best days of the year. هكذا وصفها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في حديث جابر ابن عبد الله أفضل أيام الدنيا أيام العشر من ذي الحجة. The month of ذي الحجة, brothers and sisters in Islam, is coming in 15 days. The first 10 days of this month are the best days of the year. أفضل أيام الدنيا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في حديث عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنهما said, ما من أيام العمل الصالح فيهن أحب إلى الله من تلك الأيام, يعني العشرة. There are no other days on which righteous deeds are performed are more beloved to Allah than the days that you do during these 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed the fifth pillar of Islam during these 10 days. Al-Hajj. That you go for Hajj. Subhanallah, this is the best deed that you can do. Is to go to Hajj during these days. You end up in the best place in earth. The place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose to house His house. Mecca. At the best time. At the best time. Which is the 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. فَهَذَا فَضْلٌ. What a virtue this is. Brothers and sisters in Islam, if you have not planned for Hajj this year, intend next year. And Allah will make it possible. Just have the intention. But there is a lot of misconception amongst Muslims regarding the 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. That these days they have only to do with those who go for Hajj. Those who go to Mecca. Which is incorrect. Actually, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prescribed certain deeds that you can do. These deeds, brothers and sisters in Islam, very similar to the deeds that the people who are in Hajj actually perform. Here is the first one. Hadith Salama radiyallahu anha fi sahih al-Imam Muslim. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمْ هِلَالَ ذِلْحِجَّةِ. If you see the crescent of Dhul-Hijjah, وَأَرَادَ أَحَدُكُمْ أَن يُضَحِّي. And you are the head of the family, and you're planning to offer a qurbani, sacrifice. فَلْيُمْسِكْ عَنْ شَعْرِهِ وَأَظَافِرِهِ. Let him refrain from taking any of his hair and any of his nails. The people who go for Hajj, at a certain location that the scholars and the Prophet ﷺ called it Miqat, a boundary around Mecca, they take off their dunya, their worldly garments, and they place al-ihram, a lower and upper garment, izar wa rida. And immediately, as soon as they enter into that state of ihram, one of the restrictions of that state, do not take any of your hair, do not clip your nail. You see the similarity? So this deed for you, if you are staying behind, you did not go for Hajj, that you're supposed to refrain from shaving. Shaving. Give it a chance to grow. You've been... Why? Give it a chance. Let it grow for 10 days. See how you look. It's going to be fun. Nails. طبعاً, is it mandatory to offer a qurbani? Something that has to answer, be answered. The jumhur, the majority of the jurists, they say it is an emphasized sunnah. Because the Prophet ﷺ said in the hadith that I just quoted, وَأَرَادَ أَحَدُكُمْ أَن يُضَحِّي, and you want to offer it. الجمهور على أنها سنة مؤكدة, an emphasized سنة. الليث بن سعد, الإمام الأوزاعي, and the top, الإمام أبو حنيفة, they see it واجب, mandatory. لحديث, because of a hadith that is mentioned في سنن ابن ماجه بسند صحيح, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من وجد ساعة ولم يضحي فلا يقربن مصلانا. If you're able to offer a qurbani, a sacrifice, and you do not do it, do not come to our musalla. طبعا لقول الله تعالى إن أعطيناك الكوثر فصلي لربك وانحر. Together. لذلك قال النبي. So we say, if you're able to, don't miss on the reward. So here is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that beautiful religion, that beautiful deen, is tying those who are in Hajj with those who are not in Hajj through a simple ritual, which is refraining from taking any of your hair and any of your nails for 10 days. Try it. It's fun, especially if you do it for Allah. Don't ask why. What is the wisdom? Don't. سمعنا وأطعنا. We hear and we obey. Another thing that we were commanded to do, وهذه سنة ماتت. This sunnah already buried. في حديث ابن عباس وابن عمر رضي الله عنهما, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam spoke about the virtuous days of the Hijjah, which is the 10 days of the Hijjah, he said in one of the wording, فَأَكْثِرُوا فِيهِنَّ مِنَ التَّهْلِيلِ وَالتَّحْمِيدِ وَالتَّكْبِيرِ. So during these days, make a lot of tahleel. What is tahleel? لا إله إلا الله. There is no one, no deity, no object, no human being worthy of my submission but Allah. Has the right to be submitted to but Allah. Say it loud. لا إله إلا الله. Not in the 10 days of the Hijjah. التحميد. التحميد. MashaAllah, you're so obedient. MashaAllah. التحميد. الحمد لله. الله أكبر. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud put all of this together. الله أكبر, الله أكبر, الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر, الله أكبر, ولله الحمد. By the way, هذه السنة, nobody does it anymore. We're supposed to say this loud in the first 10 days of the Hijjah until Fajr al-Arafah. And this sunnah was already abandoned even during the time of our righteous predecessors. It was authentically recorded that Abdullah ibn Umar, the narrator of the hadith, and Abu Huraira, they used to walk in the market during these days and raising their voices with these takbirat, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd. With the intention of reminding the people of the abandoned sunnah. رَفْعُ الصَّوْتِ بِالذِّكْرِ, that you raise your voice with the dhikr. لِيَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْلُومَاتٍ. Isn't that so similar with those who are in Hajj? Those who are going to Mecca? Okay, as soon as they place their Hajj garments, Al-Izar wa Rida, what they are supposed to say? With a loud voice. لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك. Oh. So they are going saying لبيك اللهم لبيك and الله أكبر الله أكبر. كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث خلاد ابن السائب ابن خلاد رضي الله عنه رضي الله عن السائب الصحابي له صحبة قال صلى الله عليه وسلم أتاني جبريل فأمرني أن آمر أصحابي أن يرفعوا أصواتهم بالتلبية فإنها من شعائر الحج. جبريل came to me and commanded me to command my companions to raise their voices with the talbiyah because it's one of the rituals of Hajj. وفي صحيح مسلم the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم something that I shared with you last week, he saw Moses in his way to Mecca performing Hajj. He was placing his fingers into his ears. رافعا صوته بالتلبية له جؤار لبيك اللهم لبيك. سيدنا موسى عليه السلام. ما هو الحج يا إخوة من شريعة إبراهيم. الحج was introduced to us سيدنا إبراهيم from the time of Ibrahim. It was revived by سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. ويقسم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في صحيح مسلم the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم swears والذي نفسي بيده. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is taking an oath and he does not need to take an oath. He was labeled by the non-Muslims before Islam to be the truthful, as-sadiq. He says, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِي, by the one in whose hand my soul is, لَيَهِلَّنَّ ابْنُ مَرْيَمَ بِفَجِّ الرَّوْحَاءِ حَاجًّا أَوْ مُعْتَمِرًا أَوْ لَيُثَنِّيهِمَا. When Prophet Isa, peace be upon him, descends towards the end of time, he will go and perform Hajj and Umrah too from a place called Fajr Rawha. طيب, here is one third thing. I just want to show you that these days are not just for the Haji. Don't say that, oh, I'm not going to Hajj. That's la. La. For you too. Here. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kama fi sunan Abi Dawood, wa Nasa'i, wa Tirmidhi, on the day of Arafah. Hadith Abdullah ibn Ya'mar. أمر مناديا ينادي في الناس الحج عرفة الحج عرفة الحج عرفة. He called one of his companions, go and call upon the people and let them know that Hajj is عرفة. What that means? The main pillar of Hajj is the day of عرفة. ليه؟ Subhanallah, you go and stand on mountains, disheveled, dusted, been traveling for days, so tired. Yani the day of Arafah comes after you have been really been doing a lot of work. Going through the immigration, the passports, take your passport, get your passport, my passport back, where is my passport? The crowded people pinching you. So you're going to Arafah, subhanAllah, disheveled, dusted, and you stand. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم والحديث في صحيح مسلم من حديث أم المؤمنين عائشة رضي الله عنها: ما من يوم أكثر أن يعتق فيه الله عبدا من النار من يوم عرفة. There is no other day on which Allah would free servants of His from the hellfire more than the day of Arafah. You got 4, 5, 6, maybe 7 million people standing in one place. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيَدْنُو. And Allah descends. We believe that Allah descends. But how He descends, we don't know. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيَدْنُو إِلَىٰ أَهْلِ الْمَوْقِفِ. He will descend on those people. And if you have been there, you feel it. If your heart is there, you really feel it. انظروا يا ملائكتي. My angels, look. هؤلاء عبادي. These are my servants. أتوني شعثا غبرا. وهذا فضل. They came to me disheveled, dusted. What do they want? أشهدكم يا ملائكتي أني قد غفرت لهم. Bear witness, my angels, that I've forgiven all of them. يعني ولذلك يعني ورد في حديث مرسل وله شاهد في موطأ مالك: ما رؤي الشيطان أدحر ولا أحقر من يوم عرفة. Satan, he put sand in his head. Why? He's been working with these people for the last probably years, and by all of a sudden, salvation, forgiven for the past. All his work is because of the mercy and the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what about you? You're not in Hajj. The day of Arafah too, you get a bonus. في صحيح مسلم حديث أبي قتادة رضي الله عنه: سئل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن صيام يوم عرفة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was asked about fasting the day of Arafah, which is the ninth day of these 10 days. قال, he said, for the non-haji, it is not a sunnah for the haji to fast this day. If you're going for hajj, it is not a sunnah. Some of the jurists consider it to be hated. Why? Because you need the strength. You're traveling, you need the strength. Fasting is not recommended. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, fi hadith Jabir, to make this crystal clear to those who are in hajj, he called upon water in front of everybody and he had a drink. This applies to those who are not in Hajj. سُئِلَ النَّبِي, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked about the virtue of fasting the ninth day of Arafah. قَالَ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, يُكَفِّرُ السَّنَةَ الْمَاضِيَةَ وَالسَّنَةُ الْمُقْبِلَةَ. 2 years. And Dhul-Hijjah, by the way, is the last month of the lunar calendar. Now, ya ikhwa, we are Muslims. We got to talk about the concept of salvation. You know, salvation. In Islam, there is nobody died for you. You have to do the work. These are the things that you have to do to gain salvation. Oh, 1 day fast, but for the sake of Allah, 2 years. You get credit for the next year, but don't sin. هذا من باب الرجاء. من باب الرجاء. طيب, another act. The 10th day of Dhul-Hijjah, subhanallah, Sacrificing is one of the acts of the 10th day of the Hijjah, as well as it is the day on which those who are not in Hajj, they offer their Qurban. So again, you see the deen, the religion is connecting those who are not in Hajj with those who are not in Hajj. The 15th day, almost today, if I'm not mistaken, of Dhul Qa'dah, you still have 15 days. I saw the moon, full moon. Just watch the moon. It's going to go down, down, down. The 0 hour, the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Don't miss on these days. Very, very virtuous days, brothers and sisters in Islam. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. On the 10th day of the Hijjah, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in another wording, fi hadith Jabir, the 9th day. Here he is. He told his companions, 120,000 almost, asahhu al-aqwal yani, khudu anni manasikakum, لعلي لا ألقاكم بعد عامي هذا. Take your rituals, learn your rituals from me. You're probably not going to see me after this year. وقبض النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. He died actually after Hajj. But in this particular sermon, which is known to us by Hajjatul Wada', the farewell sermon, he asked his companions this question, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَلَا إِنَّكُمْ مَسْؤُولُونَ عَنِّي. You're going to be asked about me. What are you going to say? In the day of resurrection, brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah will ask the people whether the messengers delivered the message or not. لِإِقَامَةِ الْحُجَّةِ عَلَيْهِمْ. Because Allah said, وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَذِّبِينَ حَتَّى نَبْعَثْ رَسُولًا. We're not going to punish anybody unless we send the messenger. قال تعالى ولنسألن الذين أرسل إليهم ولنسألن المرسلين. So Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, in that question, he's referring to that. You're going to be asked about me in the day of resurrection. What are you going to say? فقالوا رضوان الله عليهم, الصحابة, they said, نشهد إنك, نشهد أنك قد بلغت وأديت. We bear witness that you have delivered the deen. You have delivered the message. And you have showed us how to practice it. He raised his finger like this, نكث بالسبابة. اللهم اشهد. اللهم فاشهد. اللهم فاشهد. 3 times. Oh Allah, bear witness. Oh Allah, bear witness. Oh Allah, bear witness. And then he told his companions, بلغوا, go and deliver. Go and deliver this religion to humanity. بلغوا عني ولو آية. And he earlier told them glad tidings. He was sitting with them 1400 years ago in the desert. By Allah, this religion will reach as far as the dark and the daylight reaches. Imagine this 1400 plus years ago. Wallahi, you are a testimony for this. Yani, subhanAllah, one of the most amazing statistics, here's Jazakallah Abu Umar. Islam is the most negatively spoken about religion in the whole world. Look at the other piece of this. Islam is the most growing religion in the world. Can you put the two together? إن الله ينصر هذا الدين بالرجل الفاجر. سبحان الله. فالحمد لله, we are in Denver. And Allah knows best how long we're going to be here in this world. But it is our responsibility to prepare the next generation, to build the next generation who will carry on delivering the message, the peaceful message of Islam. Wallahi, it's so peaceful. In a peaceful way. Preparing and building the next generation, brothers and sisters in Islam, takes three institutions. Home, believing parents, parents who are committed to the deen. The home also looks like a Muslim home. The other day I was visiting somebody, I'm not going to say who it is. I entered into the bathroom, I found him having magazines in the bathrooms. Ya Rajli, ihrab, hada makan al-shayateen ya Rajli. Run away, this is the place where shayateen. A'udhu billahi min al-khubthi wal-khaba'at. Hatit li majalla ashal aqad ma'ahum. Mashili ya raja, aiz akhallas b'sura. Tudkul bayt al-muslim al-an, hatit lak al-sura ala the pictures on the wall. Tabi akhi, Nabi sallam yaqul, al-malaika la tadkul hadha al-bayt. Angels do not enter that house. الملائكة لا تدخل بيتا فيه صورة وكلب. And we're not anti-dogs here. We like the dogs. We were told that a woman went to paradise because of giving a drink to a dog. But showing love to the dog does not mean that you keep them in the house. No. How often you play the Quran in your home? How often you have a meeting with your family where you talk to them about the deen? Ma huwa hadha wal muslim hum. Muslim hum. Do you wake up your child in the morning? Wake up to pray fajr or wake up to go to school? Isha hadha asha tuh al madrasa. Wake up to go to school. Al wad encrypted in his mind now in the madrasa more important than the salah. Don't say that the sheikh is not. No, schools are important. Wake up to pray and then I will take you to school. Hada wal Muslim home. When was the last time you brought your son to the masjid? Your daughter to the masjid? But before you bring them, teach them the etiquettes of the masjid. Something that really bothers me, parents, we have that weekend school. Parents, they come pick up their children. The dismissal time is 1:30, which is when we have the jama'ah for dhuhr. شوف يستنى ابنه في العربية برا to pick him up. He would wait for his son or daughter outside. He would not come to the masjid to pray jama'ah مع الجماعة. يا راجل, let your child see you in the masjid. One of the moments that stays in the back of your head when you see your father prostrating in the masjid. Ah, my father. لأن حب الآباء هذا مشكلة. The love for the parents, سنة الآباء هذه. So why are we having time with changing the ummah? Because of سنة الآباء. إن وجدنا آباءنا على أمة وإن على آثر مقتد. Listen يا شيخ, I found my father doing this, I'm not going to change. ليه؟ لأنه بحب أبوه. بس the negative side of love. His love to his father drives him not to adhere to the religion because his father was not doing it. يعني تأتي للأخ يقول له, you're better than my father, you love me more than my father. So fathers, home fathers can be a hindrance for the children, but if they are utilized, killers. They do the job. Masjid, we ask Allah to bless our masjid. But here is the third piece that is needed, brothers and sisters in Islam, is a school. We need a school. It is not fair for your children to bring them up in that home that you have, and then till the 8th grade in Crescent View Academy, and then you go and throw them in public school. It's not going to work. These are very sensitive years of the life of your teenager. And you're going to be asked about your child in the day of resurrection. You probably know what I'm talking about. Tomorrow, brothers and sisters in Islam, we're having that fundraising for Al-Ihsan Academy, our high school. This is a community project. We're working hard on this project. A lot of the brothers behind the scene are working so hard. Alhamdulillah, phase one is successful, bifadlillah ta'ala. So beautiful to see 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th grades running around the masjid here, receiving their education in that environment. But as we know, we cannot hold a full-time school in that building. Based on an agreement that we done with the county and our neighbors, that phase we cannot use. We have to honor our contracts or go back to them and ask a permission. That's how a Muslim should behave. For tomorrow, inshallah, brothers and sisters, we're having our fundraising to find a building for Al-Ihsan Academy. This is the first of the fundraisings, inshallah, in a series of them, not necessarily here. But if we do not receive the support of the community, it is not going to be fun. Bi-idhnillah ta'ala, as soon as I return from my journey, Hajj, bi-idhnillah, may Allah accept from all of us, I'm planning to travel across America and raise funds for Al-Ihsan Academy. Bi-idhnillah. Is a dream, is a vision that we must deliver. We owe it to our children. I expect to see all of you there tomorrow. Please. The address, the tickets are being sold outside. Don't let our youth down. Even if you're not going to give, just come. Show up. Show your support. Brothers and sisters in Islam, بإذن الله تعالى, on Sunday, after Asr till Isha, I will be holding Hajj workshop for those who are going for Hajj, to explain to them the rituals. Join us as well, inshallah. Or if you want to get ready for next year, you can join us as well, inshallah. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا, إسرافنا في أمرنا, وثبت أقدامنا.